Hello guys, welcome back. As you can see, Wolf is a bit sleepy. It's 3 o'clock in the afternoon here at the moment. Wolf, get your ball. Obedient good dog. And a very good friend, also a very good manager, because with his help I'm able to make this. In today's video we're going to do some painting. This video will be one video for you, but several days for me. Before we begin, let me show you a couple of things. First of all, I have trimmed everything. You see, let me get some focus. You see that everything is perfect, and also with some wood putty wherever it needed. As you see, it's just perfect, both sides. Also, I have assembled the base that is inside the box. As you can see, the glue is still wet, so I'm not going to do anything until the glue is dry, because I'm going to need this particular base. What I need to do, according to the plans, is make a mark 5 centimeters from the keel and all the way up. I have to make a mark from stern to bow. That's not easy to do, but I have improvised, and I'm going to show you what I have done next. What I can see here is that I have to paint the top side black, the lower side black, and the parts that are in between here, between the lower and middle rubbing strake, white. In the drawings you can see that it's showing paint black and then the white above. I'm not going to do that. There's no point of doing that. Why paint black and above the white? The white is a difficult color, so why use extra layers of white, extra coats, if you can avoid that? No reason. So what I'm going to paint is the top black, the lower black, and the middle white. But of course I'm going to paint the black first. Many corrections will be done, I'm pretty sure about that. The only problem is to draw the line that I need to have a reference point, so that everything underneath is up to the first rubbing strake is painted black. That is why I'm going to need this little base and this little construction that I made. It's simply easy. It's nothing weird. As you can see, I have made a column out of spare parts, spare wood, 2 pieces here. Give me a moment. This is Wolf's ball. Come on, Wolf. Get your ball. So let's get back to what I was saying. This is just 2 pieces that I have placed together. These pieces are glued. They are screwed down to a base, so this can move around. The idea is to hold it like this and move it. And as you can see, I have cut open the middle side. I have placed 2 screws with nuts, and with these 2 also pieces I have cut the pencil in the middle, and I can move it up and down to where the ever height I like. So I'm going to be able to draw a line like this. Pretty simple as a construction, took me around 30 minutes. just to find the pieces that I needed and to open up the middle part. So guys, after the glue here is dry, that's going to be several hours, I'm going to begin the painting. First of all, we're going to use some wood sealer. That's definitely mandatory when you have to paint wood surfaces. And then I'm going to draw the line and start with the black. So give me some hours for me, for the glue to dry on the base, and just a moment for you, and I'll get back to you. Now guys, what I'm going to do is apply a coat of wood sealer in the entire hull, and then I will be able to do any of the other works, jobs, to draw the line, to be able to paint and stuff. So this is wood sealer. If anyone wants to know what type of wood sealer is this, you can ask me. It's a nitro wood sealer. At the moment I don't remember the number, because it has a number, and if you want to know, ask me and I will tell you. This wood sealer dries very, very quickly, so until I finish the one side, the other side will be dry. If anyone wonders why you should apply wood sealer, the reason is simple. The wood has pores. If you do not apply wood sealer, then you will be having a very big trouble applying the paint. You will need many coats, and definitely the result is not going to be as good as it should be. So that's the idea, guys. Let me do it both sides, and I'll get back to you to show you the finished result. As you can see, it's painted. Here it's dry. On the other side, it's not dry yet. It needs 5 minutes or more, and it will be completely dry. Then I'm going to use this, and I will count 5 centimeters from the keel and all the way up, to draw a line from bow to stern. I have to adjust this, and I also going to use this base. This is included in the box, so I have to adjust this according to this base and to the ship. So this height plus the 5 centimeters draw a line. So I will do that and I will get back to you to start painting. And it's done, guys. It's completely dry. And as you can see, I have already drew the line. Here the back, the stand, it was quite a bit difficult, even with the construction that I made. Over here you can see, I have to make it even. I will do that by hand, and I will use masking tape. I have it right here, to mask everything from this line below, because from this, excuse me for that, sorry for that, from this side, from this line and above, it's going to be painted. So I will do some masking, nothing serious, just some tape that I'm going to glue all the way from bow to stern. You can see the line, and I'll get back to you to start painting. Now guys, as you can see, I have placed some tape and masked the entire part of the lower hull that I don't want to get painted. I followed the line, don't know if it's visible at some points. Definitely I'm going to make corrections when the tape is off. That's something that it's certain. Also here you can see the line. Now what we're going to paint. According to the plans, it says paint all the upper part black and then paint the interior, the inside the lines white. I'm not going to do that because the white is a very difficult color, and when I paint it black, it's going to be harder. So what I'm going to do is paint the black areas black, and the white areas I will leave them to last to paint the white when the black is done. Definitely I'm going to make some adjustments and the micro painting over there too. So let's see what is black and what is white. Up to this part, up to this rubbing strake, and the underneath is black. The side of this rubbing strake and also this rubbing strake up to the side is white. The upper part of this rubbing strake and all the way to the rails is black. Okay. This ship, this model, like I said before, I'm building it for a friend. So, I asked him what the colors and the varnish should be, matte, satin or gloss. It's a free country, even so that these days doesn't remind me something like that, probably because it is not. I am in Greece, where democracy began thousands of years ago, and today we're living like in a military law. Okay, but in my channel everyone gets his opinion, and of course my friend could choose between the three, satin, gloss and matte color and varnishing of his model. Guess what? He chose gloss. So gloss paint here, gloss paint here, gloss paint here, gloss varnish in the entire model. Let me shake up the color and I'll get back to you to start painting. Let's begin. I'm going to do the upper part first, because or the lower part, the upper. What you see here is wood sealer, of course, wood varnish. Definitely the black is going to be painted with two coats, maybe three, but I believe two is going to be enough. The white, I don't believe three is going to be enough. In a similar model, I used five coats of white.
The paint brush, as you see, it's flat, so it will help me a lot. So you get the idea, let me do it all and I'll get back to you to show you the finishing result. And done, guys. One coat of black, one coat of white. As you can see, I have left the rubbing streaks at the side without any color because the color is wet and I don't want them to mix up. I will do the white when I finish with the black. That means that I have to do definitely another coat of black. And when the black is dry, then I will start painting the white. But then again, this is light color wood, so the white is going to take a couple of coats. Here, the dark color wood, as you can see, I will need definitely 3 coats and maybe more, but definitely 3. So this is how the ship looks now. It's just the first coat without any corrections, not a sloppy job, but needs a lot of work more. And also here, as you can see at the bow, this is wrong. This needs to be a little bit further high with the black. But okay, nothing to worry about. The black is easy over the white. So, this is the procedure, guys. Me and Wolf, who once more prefers the floor than his bed. Here I have somewhere, here is ball. Yeah, his ball. And we need the brushing. So, me and Wolf, we salute you and will be very happy to see you in our next video when I will definitely have finished the painting and we will proceed with the next step. Next step, probably something like that over there.